talking to head football coach Pete Shinnick about his 2013 football schedule. Coach, on paper, it looks like a pretty difficult schedule, one of the most difficult the Braves have faced so far.
Yeah, I think in our history, you know, our brief young history here, this is by far the most challenging schedule that we've had going into a season. Obviously, a lot can change as you go, through the course of a season. But looking at it, as we sit here right now, we definitely have our hands full and we've got great competition. One of the things you want to do in Division II is maximize your strength of schedule with your Division II games. And so we've got 8 Division II games. I believe we've hit on all cylinders of trying to maximize what that strength of schedule will be based on last year's performances.
Strength of schedule, talk about that right away. You jump right into it. Two things special about the opening game on your schedule. One, it's against the national runner-up, one of your biggest region rivals. And two, it's on a Thursday night. I mean, just talk about that opener. You can't open a season better than that.
I really don't think so. I think we're going to have a great crowd. It's going to be a great event. First Thursday night game in the history of the program. The opportunity to play the number 2 team in the country coming out of the gate. It's going to be great for our fans. Winston-Salem's fans travel really well, so we expect it to be a packed house. We expect it to be a great atmosphere.
Let's talk about go on the road to Fayetteville State the next week. Then you go to make a rare trip to Wilmington, North Carolina. The first installment of the Cape Fear Classic. You play Shaw over there. What sort of things went into planning that game, and when did that first when did the plans first start materializing?
Yeah, we started talking about that probably midway through the season, and just the opportunity to go down and play in Wilmington, looking for another Division II opponent to be a part of that. Great to have Shaw on the schedule. And I think to play a game in Wilmington, kind of a neutral site, obviously. I think Shaw will be home this year and will be home theoretically next year, as it is a 2-year agreement. Really plays well with us. It's an area that we've never played a game in. Obviously, they don't have D2 or D1 football there. So we're excited to get down, play in front of the Wilmington crowd, and to play another really quality Division II opponent. Obviously, FSU under new leadership, always a challenging game for us. We're looking to continue that, keep the Two Rivers Classic Cup here on campus.
Now, you come back home after that game, face Wingate, one of your better crowds. Always have good crowds, whether it's here or there. Mm-hmm. Then you have an open week, and then what a lot of Braves fans will be excited about, and you've been in this situation before, first-year program, but we head up the road a little bit to play at UNC Charlotte.
Sure. No, Wingate, touching on that, I think that that game and that rivalry has turned into be every year going to be decided by a few points. And we were fortunate last year. That game has been very, very close the last couple years. The opportunity to play UNC Charlotte in their first year, our first time playing a scholarship FCS program, we're very excited about that. They have put together a very impressive recruiting class this year as well as last year. So it's going to be a great challenge for us, but I think it's going to be a neat opportunity for our guys play in their new stadium, see their new facilities, and I think there's going to be a great crowd. So looking forward to having that opportunity for our players.
Now, after the UNC Charlotte game, that starts a 3-game road trip. You go to Catawba, you go to Newberry, third SAC opponent in a row. You come home, play Tuscum on homecoming. Talk about homecoming and what sort of atmosphere that brings for your team.
Well, I think after you mentioned, we'll be on the road for 3 weeks, and to play 3 tough SAC opponents in a row, to be at home, I think will be a great relief for our guys. Tusculum, they always are dangerous on offense and extremely creative on defense. We've had, good success against them the last couple years. They've done a great job improving through this recruiting season. So we know we're going to be challenged. Catawba is going to be under new leadership, and Newberry, our games have been extremely close. So we've got a great 3-SAC opponent run right there that I think is going to be very challenging for us to be able to get through that.
Now, although you do close out your season, your regular season at home against Virginia University of Lynchburg, you do have an important date in second weekend in November. Go on the road and face the defending national champion at Valdosta State.
Yeah, Valdosta, obviously, we're one of the few teams probably in the country over the last 10 years that have played the number one and number two teams in the country. I'm not sure that many people have had the two teams that played in the national championship on their schedule, but we are always looking for anybody who wants to play us. And when you're an independent, you'll schedule whoever you can, wherever you can. I'm really looking forward to the opportunity to go down to their place, experience that atmosphere, talk to a lot of coaches about what it's like to play at Valdosta. We signed a 2-year agreement, so they're going to be coming back up to our place the following year. But just I think a great way for us to kind of have an idea of where we are at that time in the season. Very well-respected program, obviously, not just last year. They've been very good for a long time. And then the closeout at home, I think, will give us a great idea as to where we're at. Send our seniors off, hopefully, on a great final note.